What's up, you guys? Megan here with another video. In this video, I thought we would take a look at the part 4 of the Alex Aiono and William Singe collab. I'm not sure if they're gonna like keep making parts and like keep going, but I'm super excited that they are doing like more collabs together. So I have reacted to the part 3 already, which was on Alex's channel, and last week I did react to part 1 and part 2. You should definitely go check all those out if you haven't already. And yeah, I'm super excited. I'm sure that I'm gonna have something to say afterwards. Usually I always feel like I start out by watching them and like reacting to them, like thinking in my head, oh my god, you know what, I feel like I'm not gonna have anything to say because I just like reacted to a ton of their like music, so I feel like, you know, there's only like so much that you can comment on. But every time they like have something come up or they upload like a new video, they literally like, I just have so many new like thoughts and like, you know, comments come to mind. So yeah, let's just get right into it because I don't want to keep babbling. So yeah, without further ado, let's get right into the reaction. Oh. Wait, his voice reminds me of somebody. Who is that? Ooh! It kind of sounds like Jason Derulo. Wow, their falsetto, I feel like strengthened a lot more. But stay woke. Brothers creeping. Cool. Go catch a sleeping. Now stay woke. Cause brothers creeping. Now don't you close your eyes. I feel like as I was reacting, like my just like my, I kept like moving back because I was like, what is happening? Sometimes it's like hard for me to express in words or like even like facial expressions, like how much I'm actually like in love with what they do, because I don't know, I feel like it just doesn't like justify their like greatness. I don't even know like what to call it. So first of all, I said this like during the actual reaction, but their falsetto is surprisingly like strong. I think that usually whenever someone goes into a falsetto, you can tell like immediately they're not as like strong up there. Not even like strength wise, but just like dynamic wise and like loudness wise, they are like weaker up there. And I think that's just like that's a force of nature. I feel like whenever you're not in your normal like octave, you're obviously going to be like a little bit like, you know, not as strong, not as powerful. But honestly, I think because they've been practicing up there, as in like they've been like covering and they've been singing up there a lot, it's like strengthened a lot. So I can definitely hear like a difference from like, I think, I don't even know like what example I could give, but they're like earlier covers where they did go into their falsetto a lot, but it was definitely, you could tell that it was weaker versus like here where it's almost at the same like level of their like normal voice, I would say. Love that. And these two like parts, part 3 and part 4, they like used even less amount of instruments, honestly. Like that just, it like makes such a huge difference because you can tell You can hear their voices like super well. Usually like when you're in the studio and you have like a bunch of like background music, or not even that, but like you have some sort of like bass or some sort of like beat going on, it's hard for you to like really listen to the voice itself, because you're always like jamming out to the beat, or you're always like, you know, you have that like raw like bass line going on, so there's always some sort of backbone or some sort of like foundation to the like music of the song that they're singing. So I just feel like because they've been singing a lot, that like their control has gotten a lot better, their like clarity has gotten a lot better. It's like the only analogy that I can think of is like if like right now, just because it's summertime, and also on a side note, in college you don't write like nearly as much as you do in like high school, but the only analogy that I can like compare this to is like in the summer, I remember like in school, whenever like because you're writing the entire school year, and then suddenly in June you're like not writing as much because obviously like you're not taking tests, you're not doing papers, you're not doing all that kind of stuff, you're mostly like even if you are like taking classes or if you're doing work or something, it's usually like online, or you don't have to like write nearly as much as you do during the actual school year. So like your handwriting sort of like deteriorates, not to the point where it's not like legible, but like a little bit. Like I remember at least like this used to happen a lot in middle school. It did happen some time in high school, but not as much. But like I used to not write that much for 3 months, and then I used to go back in like August, like September, and like whenever I'm like writing the date or like writing my name, my handwriting used to be like super weird and like not normal, and like my hand used to like feel weird like writing. I don't know why. So I just feel like they have been practicing so much that they're like, this is like the May, June time of the school year for them. Like they have like the great handwriting, they have like the great like handwriting grip, like with your like, you know, I don't know where I'm going with this, but you know, like you understand, like the analogy here is like the script to their singing. So yeah, that's pretty much all I got for this video. If you did enjoy, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you're not already. I post Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Usually, I know for the past like couple of weeks it's been kind of messy, but starting this week, I promise everything will be back to normal. So you definitely should subscribe if you haven't already, and definitely turn on my post notifications if you haven't done that already. Go follow me on Twitter and Instagram. I'm going to be having a Q&A soon, so you definitely should go do that. And I promise I'm going to be more active on both social medias. I'm sorry. I haven't been super active, but I will be. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys are having a great day or night, depending on whenever you're watching this. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.